children,
all of you have seen all these variety of pebbles or stone in your surrounding. You can find out the colors are different. It is reddish in color, it is blackish in color, and this is used as your construction material. So dear children, how the color is varying, from where all these come from? So today I am going to teach you about the different types of rocks which are found in your surrounding. And it is a part of your third chapter, that is the surface and interior of the earth, and the subtopic is the earth, a treasure of rock material. So what is rock? Two terms are there, rock and mineral. What is a rock? Rock is a naturally occurred hard substance, solid substance. It may be hard or it may be soft. It can be hard like the marble, and it may be soft like the piece of chalk. So dear children, though it naturally occur, but on the basis of its formation, the process of formation, there are three types of rocks. If you think about the minerals, what are minerals? How minerals are different from rock? Minerals are also naturally occurred substances, but they have a definite chemical composition. The rocks do not have. And if you compare a piece of rock and a piece of mineral, mineral will be harder and it is having a different sign or luster which the rocks do not have. Dear children, all of you have seen the gold jewelries which are being used by your mother. They have a different sign, isn't it? So in the same way, so many variety of minerals are there, so many variety of rocks are there in our surrounding. So all are different from each other. So on the basis of the formation, the rocks are categorized into three types. So first we'll discuss about igneous rock. In the last video, I have discussed about the different layers of the earth's interior. What are the layers? Crust, mantle and core. So dear children, in the inside, already I told you previously that the temperature is very high. So whatever the things are present inside, they are changed into a semi-molten type of material, semi-solid material, which is called as magma. And where they are found? They are found in the magma chamber inside the earth, where the magma is stored, or these molten materials are stored, that is called magma chamber. So sometimes, as they are always trying to come out, sometimes your mother is boiling water at your home, you might have seen, if it is covered with a lid, you will find that vapor is pushing that lid to come out. In the same way, the hot material which is present inside, called as magma, that is also pushing the rock strata to come out. And when they got any crack or any weak zone, they comes out. So the pipe like which through which it comes out, that is known as volcanic pipe. And when it comes out, it comes in contact with the different weather changes, and there it solidifies. So that forms igneous rocks. So igneous rock, the word igneous means coming out of fire. So as because of the high temperature, the molten materials here coming out, getting deposited here, and then it forms the rock which is called as your igneous rock. There are two types of igneous rock. It can be intrusive igneous rock or it may be extrusive igneous rock. What is intrusive igneous rock and what is extrusive igneous rock? Just here you see children, when the magma comes out, it is called as lava. That is called as lava, and it cools down and solidifies here. And with the time, the rock which is formed in the outside on the earth surface, that is called extrusive igneous rock. But when sometimes what happened, this magma that got certain way to come out from the magma chamber, but that is not able to come out completely to the earth surface. So in the interior, somewhere else from the magma chamber, it cools down. So there the rock which is formed, that is called intrusive igneous rock. Internally it is formed, inside it is formed, that is why it is called intrusive igneous rock. But when it comes out, the rock which is formed, that is called extrusive igneous rock. Just like your external and internal, only two terms, where it is, when it is formed in external part, that is called extrusive igneous rock. When it is formed in the inside, that is called intrusive igneous rock. For example, igneous, extrusive igneous is your basalt. You might have seen in your surrounding this small chief feature there. Used for your construction purposes, these small chips, these are the pieces of basalt. And like intrusive igneous rock, that is your granite. This you might have been using at your home, your parents are using. So that is, this is a piece of granite and it is an example of intrusive igneous rock. One concept is there that intrusive igneous rocks have larger crystals, mineral crystals, whereas extrusive igneous rocks, they have smaller crystals. Why is it so? Because when it comes out, that cools down because of, it may be because of rainfall, maybe of the wind, when it comes in contact with different weather changes, that cools down within no time. That's why the crystal which is formed, that is called, that is smaller in size, but inside it takes a longer period of time to cool down. That is why larger crystals are formed. You have seen these sugar pieces, misri you are saying. So these solid pieces, these are larger crystals at your home we are using. But if you see about the sugar, these sugar are smaller crystals. Now I think you are able to understand. Sugar is smaller crystal, whereas this misri, it is larger crystal. In the same way, on the earth surface, there are the minerals are formed or the rocks are formed in different sizes of crystals. The color may vary, the size may vary. That depends on how it is being formed, the process, how it is formed. So these rocks are also known as primary rocks. Why primary? Because they are first formed on the earth surface. Sometimes in one mark question it is asked, why igneous rocks are known as primary rocks? Because they are first formed on the earth surface. And after its formation, as you know, on the earth surface, there are the weather of agents or agents of gradation. They are always on their work. That means weathering and erosion always taking place. So that is why that they started eroding that. When the layers of the igneous rocks are being eroded and being taken away by the rivers or the running water, that gets deposited in layers, one after the another, in the seabed or ocean bed. So when layer wise it will be deposited, those sediments, those small particles which are brought down by the rivers, those are called as sediments. Those sediments that get deposited layer wise, one by one. So just you see, this is, if this is the lower layer, this layer is putting pressure on this. The next layer which is lying above, again that is putting pressure on the lower layer. So when layer increases, the pressure increases, and as you know, temperature is also high. Because of high temperature and pressure, that gets changed to sedimentary rock. This is the second type of rock which is being formed due to the deposition of sediments in the sea or ocean bed. that is called sedimentary rocks. As they are formed layer wise, they are called as stratified rock. One word is there, stratified, stratified rock. Sometimes in one mark question it may be asked, why these are known as stratified rock? Because they are formed layer wise. And dear children, in this layer, sometimes the remains of the plants and animals that get buried under this layer. So when they get buried under this layer, because of the pressure of the overlaying rocks and the temperature, high temperature, they get changed to fossil fuels. And as you know, it may be coal, it may be petroleum, it may be natural gas. All these are fossil fuels which are having a great economic importance. How? Because they are being used as a source of energy. They are the source of energy which is utilized in different industries. The next type of rock is your metamorphic rock. What are metamorphic rock? Metamorphic rock means, this is the third category of rock. This rock, metamorphic. When due to more heat, that means intense heat and pressure, it may be sedimentary rock, it may be igneous rock. Anyone that gets changed to a new variety of rock, means its color changes, its character changes, characteristics. So that forms a new type of rock which is known as metamorphic rock. Metamorphic rock, the process in which it is formed, it is known as metamorphism. So in that process, due to high heat and high pressure, the color, the texture, the hardness of the rock get changed. And the new type of rock which is formed, that is called metamorphic rock. So how it gets changed? So like limestone, have you heard the name limestone? Limestone get changed to this piece of marble. People compare limestone and marble. Marble is harder also. So next slide. Sometimes granite, this granite that get changed to gneiss, that is another form of rock. And like sometimes the slate or shale gets changed to slate. Dear children, in exam you have to write sometimes with example what is metamorphic rock. Write with example. So here you will write, like limestone is a sedimentary rock, but in the process of metamorphism it gets changed to marble. So marble is metamorphic. Like granite is igneous that gets changed to gneiss, that is a metamorphic rock. So dear children, in the nature this process continues. Again it will be this, like at first your because of volcanic eruption, rocks are formed which are called as igneous rock. Then igneous rock is subjected to weathering and erosion with the help of agents of gradation. It may be wind, it may be glacier, it may be the tides or the waves, we have already discussed earlier, and that converted into sediments. From sediments, sedimentary rock is formed, and from sedimentary rock again metamorphic rock is formed due to the high heat and high pressure. So this cycle continues in the nature, which is known as rock cycle. So dear children, go through the book for your better understanding. It's a very easy concept. Simply remember, there are three types of rock on the basis of formation: igneous, then sedimentary and metamorphic. Igneous is of lava origin or volcanic origin. Then your sedimentary rocks are originated from the sediments, which are because of the deposition of sediments in the layer. And the metamorphic rock, it may be igneous, it may be like sedimentary rock, when under heat and pressure that gets changed to a different type of rock is formed, that is called as your metamorphic rock. So this is all for today. We'll again have a new video for the new part of your chapter. Thank you.